and welcome to the award-winning Waterman Wellness, your pathway to health and wellness with local experts as your guides. I'm Jenna Kreger. Coming up in this month's episode, it may look like science fiction, but local surgeons are relying more on robots to help treat patients. They'll explain shortly. We'll clear up a misconception that many men might have about urination problems and tell you about a 5-second test that could save your life. And you'll find out why a Lake County specialist is calling these youngsters hometown heroes. We begin with a local hospital's accomplishment that is important to Lake County residents. A national third-party organization that reviews how hospitals keep patients safe has once again issued its report card. Florida Hospital Waterman is the only hospital in Lake County to have received an A grade for spring 2016.
There's probably over 2,500 hospitals that get graded from them. The easiest way to explain it would be is like your letter grade in school. So they take 30 measures, 15 process and 15 outcome measures, and they put it into a formula and it comes out with a letter grade between A and F. And then they award those in the spring and in the fall. So that's our 7th A in a row. And it's significant because it really shows the community that patient safety is number one priority for every part of our hospital. There really isn't a part of this hospital that isn't touched in this process, even including our volunteers. And we always put that through to everyone that comes in the doors. They all go through the same orientation process to understand that every single one of them is a patient safety advocate. And we are the ones that are here for our patients to make sure that they leave in a better state than when they came to us in the hospital.
To further emphasize the significance of the accomplishment, Florida Hospital Waterman is one of only 41 hospitals in the state to receive the A grade.
Many of us live in the area, we work in the area, and our families and our friends and our neighbors all are treated here at the hospital. So I think it's important for them to know that they can be proud to where they come to work, and our patients and our families and all of our, anyone that even comes to visit in our county knows that they can come here and receive safe care.
Want more information about the hospital safety score? Visit the website on your screen to learn how to find the safest care in your community. Next, a local heart specialist is crediting some Mount Dora third graders for saving a life. Earlier this year, Triangle Elementary students sprung into action when their substitute teacher collapsed in front of them.
60-year-old female, no known medical history, is getting ready to teach her third grade class as a substitute teacher, and shortly after class started, had a cardiac arrest, went down in front of a group of 8 and 9-year-olds. Within an incredibly short period of time, one or two of the students responded. They had gone out and got help from the school nurse, pressed the panic room button, and within what probably couldn't have been more than 2 minutes, the response team showed up to the room.
The woman was brought to Florida Hospital Waterman, where the emergency team was ready for her.
It became very clear to the heart team that she required emergency bypass surgery. She was taken to the operating room and had an emergency triple vessel bypass, which is a very common operation for us to do. This was just a very uncommon circumstance. After surgery, she actually recovered pretty briskly. Within about 48 hours after surgery, she was separated from all the support that she needed. Within about another day after that, you know, she was up starting to walk around, and she left the hospital about 8 or 9 days after surgery, completely intact. What's hard to assess in real time during a post sudden cardiac arrest or sudden cardiac death event is not so much whether the vital signs will come back to normal, which hers did, but what if any are going to be the neurologic consequences. What becomes a little more challenging as far as out of hospital is the amount of time that the patient is quote unquote down, meaning that their vital signs either are non-existent or they're in the progress of CPR. The brain is the least tolerable organ in the body to low blood flow or to low oxygen supply.
Recently, Dr. Allen visited the students to commend them for their quick action and to further explain what to do in the event of a medical emergency. He was joined by the teacher, Martha Ballou, whose life they had helped save.
I don't remember much. I don't remember what they did. It's just from what people were telling me what they did. Just thankful for them and for everything, you know, for them to go in and get the people to help and for not panicking.
Dr. Allen stresses that it is critical to get help immediately when faced with a medical emergency.
To go from an out-of-hospital cardiac arrest or sudden death to walking out of the hospital 8 or 9 days later intact is really an alignment of the planets. The recognition of the disease needs to be almost instantaneous. So we feel very good about our ability to train the staff, to certainly work with closely with AMS, but to be able to have the opportunity to have elementary school care. This is really pretty remarkable. I've done 4,000 or 5,000 heart surgeries. I've been in practice for about 15 years, and not only have I not done this, I haven't even heard of this. So it really is truly remarkably a one in a million or one in a billion event.
I always pray that the doctors, that, you know, God is the pilot, Him bless them, and they do what they do best, and He did what He did best, and that's why I walked out.
You'll find a number of heart health resources at the website fhwatermanheart.com. Plus, you can even take a quiz to assess your heart risk. Next, we turn our attention to the guys and the common conditions associated with the prostate. Doctors say cancer is the disease that most comes to mind, but there's another condition that's even more common.
More commonly, prostatitis, which is an inflammatory condition of the prostate, and BPH, which stands for benign prostatic hyperplasia, but we think of it as overgrowth of the gland consistent with aging. Said differently, as men age, the prostate grows along with them, and it doesn't do much in the way of growing until puberty. It stays relatively dormant until about 40, 50 years old. And it's at that point that it starts to cause problems such as urinating at night, having trouble urinating, taking longer than one wants to start that urine stream. Screening tests for BPH really just involves monitoring one's own habits. There are ultrasounds we can do to find out if someone's emptying their bladder well, and special urine capture devices we can use to assess the flow rate with which someone urinates. Prostate cancer almost always presents asymptomatically, and generally when it does have symptoms at presentation, it's a higher stage disease process. The screening that's available for prostate cancer specifically includes a digital rectal examination, or DRE. This is the prostate check. This is the part of the examination that most men are not genuinely looking forward to, mostly because they remember it differently than how it actually occurs. It's a 5-second test. And it gives a significant amount of data to the urologist or the primary care provider. The other more commonly known test is a PSA. It's a blood draw, and a blood draw is very easy. The current recommendations are that PSA screening begins in men without risk factors at age 50 and continues annually until a gentleman is 75 years young or has less than 10 years life expectancy. For men who have risk factors, the screening can start as early as 40 years young. Risk factors would include African American heritage, obesity, high-fat diet, and family history, most importantly. So when a fellow who's 50 years young, who's Caucasian, who has no other risk factors, no family history, comes in, that's when it's time to start with a digital rectal exam and a PSA. Someone with risk factors who comes in at 39 should be aware that next year we're going to start screening them.
If you or your loved one would like to find a specialist to discuss prostate issues, visit our website fhwaterman.com. It's time to take a short break, but we'll have plenty more when Waterman Wellness continues. Looking for summertime activities for the entire family? Stay tuned to learn about some fun and good for health programs. You'll learn how to sweeten up salads in a healthy way when we visit the Conry Creation Health Center kitchen. And you'll find how local specialists are using high-tech robots to treat patients right here in Lake County. You'll find additional health and wellness information in Waterman Wellness Magazine. Visit watermanwellness.com to arrange for home delivery, and you'll also find a listing of the specialists featured in this month's episode. First, Waterman Wellness has some upcoming events you might want to attend. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the award-winning Waterman Wellness, your pathway to healthy living with help from local experts. I'm Jenna Kreger. The use of robotic technology is becoming more prevalent in our everyday lives. But did you know that robots now play a large role in the field of medicine? Specialists right here in Lake County are utilizing robotic and computer-assisted technology for orthopedic procedures.
We use the robot to help us resect the bone during surgery. And what that helps us do is be very precise with how much bone we need to take off.
Doctors also use robotic technology to help alleviate arthritis pain.
If you have isolated arthritis to one localized area of the knee, you can do what's called a makoplasty or a resurfacing procedure. And those procedures do not require replacing the entire knee joint. You're just replacing a small surface area or a part of the knee, whether the inside part or the lateral part. The problem with resurfacing procedures in the past is that they had a high failure rate. The one reason why they had a high failure rate was because it is very difficult to balance one portion of the knee if you're doing the medial or lateral aspect. The makoplasty addresses that with robotic instrumentation. So the patient has a CT scan. Once they have a CT scan, that is what the information is used to program the computer. And the computer takes all this information in, records it, and it calculates how much bone needs to be removed and how much needs to be replaced. And it gives you a more precise balancing than what is typically done if you just do it standard or by hand.
Most of my patients go home the same day. They're walking on it right away with a walker. Usually within a week to 2 weeks, they switch to a cane. By about 4 to 6 weeks, they're back to their normal activities without crutch, cane, or walker. The advantage is, of course, you know, it's ligament sparing. We don't cut any muscle when we do the surgery, and there's minimal blood loss and minimal bone resection.
You can learn more about advanced orthopedic procedures by visiting fhwatermanortho.com. If trying to figure out what to serve for dinner puts stress on your brain, we've got help for you. Next, we visit the Conry Creation Health Center kitchen with Caroline Rowland and the Florida Hospital Waterman team.
Eating well is just as important for your mental health as it is your physical health, and your brain needs nutrients just like the rest of your body. Today, we have a good recipe to help us with just that. We're joined right now with Florida Hospital Waterman Executive Chef Fred Scherger and also with registered dietitian Mara Gallo. Now, Mara, tell me a little bit about what we're going to be making today.
Today, we're making a beautiful fresh summer salad.
So tell me a little bit about the fruits in the recipe. Those are good for our brain health?
Definitely. Our raspberries are very high in anthocyanins, which are good for preventing cognitive decline as we age. And the plums, the dark outer skin on them, also is high in anthocyanins, which would contribute as well.
Okay, Chef Fred, tell me a little bit about how we're gonna make this.
Okay, great. First, we're gonna start with our ingredients, which is fresh spinach, fresh plums, raspberries, toasted almonds, fresh lemon, Dijon mustard, poppy seeds, rice wine vinegar, which is a sweeter vinegar, as well as honey, another sweet to balance out the acidity, and olive oil. Mara, can you talk about a little bit about the health benefits of quinoa?
Quinoa is very high in protein. It's going to help keep you full, provide some fiber for you in this meal. So you don't necessarily need another protein like chicken on this salad. Quinoa is going to give you everything you need.
Excellent, thank you. First, I'm going to start by making the dressing, which is a poppy seed vinaigrette. So I'll add my rice wine vinegar. I'll add a squeeze of lemon and get the acidity together within that vinaigrette. Next, I'll add my Dijon mustard and fresh honey for the sweetness. Get a little bit of that in there. And then, of course, I want to add a little bit of olive oil to finish the vinaigrette. Once I have the vinaigrette made, I want to take my fresh spinach. I want to place that into the bowl. My cooked quinoa, you can cook this ahead of time, chill it down. I'm going to mix that, give it a good little mix. Add my vinaigrette. Just enough vinaigrette to coat the greens of the salad so they're not too far weighted down, and the dressing evenly is distributed throughout the quinoa, giving it a nice flavor. We can take some of our plums here. We want to take a little bit of the nuts and add that in there. We get all those flavors evenly so that the vinaigrette's on there. And take our bowl. Have a nice fresh salad. And then, of course, we can top it off with some fresh toasted almonds. And it's really a nice, beautiful salad that's very healthy for you and tastes great.
If you'd like the summer salad recipe, visit watermanwellness.com. Still making summer plans? Consider doing something fun that is also good for your health. The Conn Recreation Health Center has programs planned for both children and adults. In July, children in kindergarten through fifth grade are invited to Creation Kids Gone Mad.
MAD, standing for Music, Arts, and Drama Camp. And this week-long adventure with kids will be a morning session where we will have entertainment professionals coming in and leading our kids in learning about music. Yes, and they will sing it, but they're going to learn about actual music and notes and all the parameters that are around that. They'll be working with art in terms of painting backdrops and sculpting. And then they'll be working on drama, all of this based around the Creation Health principles. And we want our children to grow up learning these principles of health, that they can make good choices and that their families can be supported in this as well. This is not just a parent's or a child experience. This is about us as families growing healthy together.
The week-long camp begins July 25th and will be held at the Conn Recreation Health Center. And how would you like to boost your brain's health? Florida Hospital Waterman is offering a program to nurture your noggin.
Optimize Your Brain, I'm so excited about this because this is a class for anyone who wants to have a great brain. It is a six-session series of DVD and workbook where we go and experience the healthy elements of a good and active brain. So if you're a professional and you want to do well at work and you want to be able to connect more completely with the emotions of those that you work with, this is going to be a class for you. If you're a parent, you're going to learn about nutrition and how even as an adult, working with our families, we can eat certain foods that will optimize our brain. If you're a student and you want to get a higher GPA, learn how to have better study skills, this is a course for you.
Optimize Your Brain begins Tuesday, July 12th at 7 p.m. The cost for the entire course is just $55. For information about these courses and to register, contact the Conn Recreation Health Center at 352-253-3965 or visit the website. We hope you've enjoyed this month's episode of Waterman Wellness, your pathway to healthy living with help from local experts. Be sure to watch for the July episode right here on Lake Sumter TV for some of the following stories. We'll have important information to help students and their grown-ups get ready for the new school year. You'll want to watch. You'll find out how treatment for painful osteoarthritis is helping Lake County residents resume an active lifestyle. And Chef Fred will toss some unexpected ingredients into a blender to make something delicious when we go back to the Conn Recreation Health Center kitchen. To learn more about the experts featured in this program, please visit watermanwellness.com. Until next time, I'm Jenna Kreger for the award-winning Waterman Wellness.